It's time for Mastering Your Money with Gary Mastrodonato.
My good friend Zig Ziglar once told me, Gary, people don't really care how much you know until they know how much you care about them.
Every week, Gary brings you up to date in the world of finance and gives you tried and true retirement tips from his office at the Masters Wealth Management Group in Oriental, North Carolina.
It's the decisions you make in life when you have a choice that will determine where you'll be in life when you no longer have a choice.
For 40 years, Gary has passionately served his clients, helping them retire with confidence.
You know, we treat all of our clients the absolute same. There are no minimums here at the Masters Wealth Management Group.
Now, let's put the wind in your financial sails and your success. Here he is, the master, Gary Mastrodonato.
Well, hi, everybody. Gary Mastrodonato, the August edition of the Mastering Your Money program. A pleasure to be with you. Boy, do we have a lot going on in this marketplace and the economy around the world, all going on simultaneously. Come on. You need the show today just to keep up with where we are in the economic forecast and inflation and rising interest rates and the House Speaker visiting China and on and on, or Taiwan, I should say. But on and on and on, rattling markets up and down based on where she happened to be yesterday and the day before and the day after. And who knows where she's going next? And it doesn't really matter because the market's going to be very volatile. And most importantly, we need to have you retire and retire safely. That's what the show is all about. Retirement Planning Distribution Specialist, the Mastering Your Money Show, officially in our 40th year of celebration. August 1 was our 40th anniversary. You'll hear the music on the break, happy anniversary music. And of course, we're celebrating all weekend long here on the Mastering Your Money program. You know, we got a lot to talk about on the program. We have a special guest, Mr. Dan Pilla. Dan is an author and a tax expert. Best way to find Dan is taxhelponline.com. We'll talk about that more during the interview. But Dan helps out thousands of people with their problems with the IRS. So he's got solutions. When you think you have a tax problem, he's the guy you want to talk to. He's probably one of the smartest people I've ever spoken to as it relates to taxation. He and another CPA, Tom Weatherall, probably the two smartest people I've ever conversed with on this very radio program in the United States on tax situations, tax problems, tax solutions, and ways to get through them with a good outcome. And that's what you really want to have done when you're following tax law. So Dan Pilla, you don't want to miss that for a minute. It's a crucial time, and especially in light of the new bill that just passed, which is the inflation hedge bill, supposed to be lower, I forget what they call it officially, but lower the cost of inflation bill, we'll call it, but it does the exact opposite. It's adding to the inflationary numbers. We'll talk about that later. And also on today's program, we're going to be talking about life insurance. Do you really need life insurance when you retire or when the kids are grown, as many people think you don't need it anymore? More and more wives are asking their husbands, honey, did you buy the life insurance? I'd feel a lot better if we had coverage if something happens to you. And remember, men normally die off 7 years before the wife. Wives think about that all the time. They think about how they're going to get by if something happens to the breadwinner, which could be you, okay? And the breadwinner is not always the man, but in most cases, we'll just assume for this conversation that it is a male, but it doesn't really matter. It could be the wife as well, or both. Both are contributing handsomely to the family economics today's age. So they both really need life insurance. And we're going to talk about that, the reasons, the types that you need to be looking at, and what it can do for you even after you're retired, and what are the costs involved? Can we afford that in retirement? So we're gonna address that as well. So a big important show today, lifetime income, keeping your money safer in this very volatile market, and at the same time, getting you through the tax problems that you could have with our special guest today, Mr. Dan Pilla. But before, as always, we'll take a pause. We honor our nation's military as we have for the last 40 years on every single show. Today is no different on our 40th anniversary show. And we honor our nation's heroes, our men and women who serve us daily right now in military in harm's way, and our veterans who have served so diligently and bravely in their past service. And we thank you for your service and keeping us out of harm's way and putting us in the position today to be free Americans in a democratic society. We thank you, veterans. Let's take a pause to thank our heroes.
And I'm proud to be an American.
Stand up next to you and if future ain't no doubt. I love this land. God bless the USA.
Always a pleasure to hear the honor to our military, and we thank you again for your service. And, of course, police officers and people that keep us safe, and all the medical people that help cure us when we're ill, we thank you as well for your service. And of course, never a financial planning fee that I will charge you with a bill in any format for any retired military, serving in military, educators, teachers. We've never charged them. You know, people ask us all the time, Jeffrey, what's the fee going to be for this? And I said, you know, 40 years ago when I got on air, I decided to honor the military on the first show. And I always thought there would never be a fee because I wanted to serve in the military when I was in college, and I couldn't pass the test because I had a physical problem. And I always give back to the veterans and the people who served before me. That's how this came about. I'm serving you for helping to keep us safe. I couldn't do it, but I can help you in that format. So thank you for what you do. And I'm going to thank my co-host, Mr. Jeff Shade, who keeps me up and about and on point and online. For all this time on the radio, Jeffrey Shade, welcome to the program. And, buddy, you are my main rock here on this program. You have no idea what you do for me. I thank you from the bottom of our hearts, sir, Mr. Jeff Shade.
Well, you're certainly welcome, Gary, and right back at you. You're my rock as well, too. Just like the listeners, I enjoy so much sitting here every week and hearing what you have to say. It's a little bit different, but it is very important information, and I find after an hour or so, I'm so much better off than I was before the show started. But I also want to take this opportunity, again, to wish you happy anniversary, Gary. You've been on the radio 40 years, August 1st. Now, they said it wouldn't last. These engineers said, we'll give them 2 weeks. And now, I mean, they're probably not with us anymore, but here you are 40 years later still doing this radio show.
I can still hear Nick Nixon and Jack Palvino at WBBF in the other room saying, the kid won't last. So give him a shot. He won't last. It's fine.
Yeah.
All good.
Well, in the 40 years, of course, you know, you've got a lot of experience that you've gained over 40 years in the radio, but also more than that, more than 41 years in practice, too. And I would imagine that that experience comes in very, very handy because you can't buy experience. You can't get experience from a textbook. How has your experience or how does your experience today help you help your clients?
Oh, my God. It's like day and night when you have experience. I'm telling you. Think about it this way. Yesterday, I was talking to a client, and we're talking about life insurance. And the client asked, why would I need life insurance? I'm retired or about to retire. Well, you need life insurance all the way through life for different reasons at different times. And experience will tell us why. In the early days, you want life insurance if something happens to you and you got young children and you got a spouse at home. You got to have money to maintain their food and their shelter and the way that you want to bring them up properly in your absence, and that's what life insurance does. Life insurance creates money that wasn't there before. It's almost like magic. Out of the blue, they can bring money into a room that wasn't there before. And to get the money into the room, you pay something called a premium to the life insurance company. It's a swap out, but the premium will never equal the amount they're going to give you. You will never pay in what you're going to get back. And I tell you that from experience, and it works this way. You see, when you put money into a life insurance plan, a young representative that's been in business 3, 4, 5 years, bless their hearts, we all have to start somewhere. But they read it from a textbook. This is why you might need it or you might not need it, or maybe we'll put this money somewhere else. But you see, I see what goes in, but being in the business 41 years, I also see the other end of what comes out, okay? So when you put life insurance into a premium, I see the death payoff on the other end or the retirement income that it's paying out to a family to keep the family together, or the husband dies prematurely and I deliver the death benefit check to the widow, the spouse, little children, big children, no children, all grown, but spouse needs money because husband's pension gets cut off, husband's Social Security gets cut off, and everything gets cut off, and all of a sudden the spouse doesn't have the income she needs to get through the rest of her life. So there's a lot of needs and reasons why, or in the case we're going to talk about in a few minutes, if you can't perform 2 of 6 of your daily activities, the life insurance will kick in during your lifetime where you, the insured, now becomes you, the beneficiary in that life insurance plan. And it works so beautiful. It's creating money like magic that wasn't there before. All of a sudden, you have nothing, and all of a sudden, you have a plan, and all of a sudden, you have a need, and it's triggered to the need, and all of a sudden, you have money. money that wasn't there before. It's created out of thin blue air. It's fabulous. And to know the peace of mind you get. You know, there's a commercial that's on, Jeffrey, right now that's kind of interesting, where they're talking about life insurance and one of the cheap term options that you have. And term insurance is fine as well. Nothing wrong with term. But the commercial has the wife asking the husband, now you did take care of, you heard about Johnny and Judith next door. Yes, I did. So you did take care of the life insurance that you promised, right, honey? I didn't get around to it today, but I was planning on getting around. Now, honey, you promised, and I haven't been sleeping well since something happened to Johnny next door. And you promised because I'm not sleeping well, and that's important enough reason to get out there and do it today while it's available. So please do that for me. He says, yes, I'll get out there and do it. And the husband doesn't do it because he's not ready to pay the premium. He doesn't want to pay extra money out, doesn't think he can afford it. It's kind of a hassle to qualify. You got to get an exam. But we handle all of that for you. We make it as simple as possible to get the life insurance. And we even send a paramed to your home so that you don't even have to leave the house. All you got to do is open the door, sit down and answer a few questions for about 20 minutes. She'll take your blood pressure, maybe take a little blood and urine, and he or she will leave and bring it back to the underwriters. The underwriters will write to your doctors, and they come up with a decision pretty quickly, yes, no, and or what the cost is going to be. And that's how it works. It's kind of simple as that. People don't want to do that for some reason, and we don't know their real reason, but I think a lot of it is nobody wants to pay the premium. In other words, everybody wants to go to heaven, but nobody wants to die. So you see the analogy there. But all in all, it all works beautifully. Now, we're going to talk about on the radio program today a reason that experience plays into this so well, because there's a lot of kinds of life insurance that you can purchase. There is term insurance, which is the least expensive way to buy insurance. There's, you know, instant term. There's 1 year term. There is 1 year renewable term. There is term with a 5 year maximum term. There's 10 year, 15 year, 20 year, all depending on your age. Some terms go to 30 years if you're young enough when you buy it initially. And the longer you go out, the higher the premium would be. And right before the show, Jeffrey and I got on the phone and we called my insurance provider that we do our business with just to find out what it would cost for a 66-year-old male in the state of North Carolina who is a non-smoker and in good health, and what it would cost to buy life insurance, say a $100,000 policy, over the course of a 20-year term. That's as long as it would go at age 66. It would go out 20 years. So what that means is the insurance would last up to 20 years till they're 86. They would pay a level premium of $2,140.11 per year. That's $2,140 a year. And that would give them $100,000 of death protection. There is no cash value, no savings, no return of premium, no nothing. Just straight coverage. Like auto insurance, if you don't crack the car up, you don't get paid. If you don't die, you don't get the money. And if you die, the $100,000 comes into to the beneficiary. And in this case, we'll say the spouse or the children. So keeps everything together in that case. The younger you are, the longer the term could be. And of course, the lower the premium. The older you are, the shorter the term becomes. So at 66, you can have a 20-year term. Now, we asked about the convertibility of that term insurance. And that means if you wanted to convert it to whole life at some point, when would the conversion have to occur? And when you're 66, it normally now has to occur with COVID. The life insurance companies have changed their underwriting policies around quite a bit. And with COVID, they want the conversion now by age 70. So if you're 70 or older, you're not going to be able to convert that. If you're 70 or younger, you can convert it to whole life without evidence of insurability. And all that means is if your health has changed from the time you bought the term at 66 to age 70, say you've become uninsurable for some reason, maybe you had a stroke or something along that line, or got into an accident where you're no longer, where it's changed your life expectancy and your outcome, or got diagnosed with a cancer or some sort of illness that could take your life earlier than normal life expectancy, you would normally not be insurable. The convertibility privilege would allow you to be insurable at standard rates if you convert by age 70. If you're above that, too late, too little, so you better just keep the term, pay the premium. And if you die along the course of the term, you're going to have the coverage. If you don't die during that period of time, the money's out the window. But there's also another option when you have term insurance or any kind of insurance, is you have the chance to sell your policy to a third party. You've probably seen the TV ads where you can buy your life insurance from companies and get quotes on TV, but you can also sell your life insurance policies that are existing to a third party as well. and they would pay you money based on your health, based on the amount of insurance you have, based on the value of the policy to them. And what do they do with it? They sell it to an investment company, and investors pay your premium. And investors will convert that to whole life. If there's a conversion privilege in it, it's worth more money because they can convert it and keep it going all the way through your lifetime. The worse health you're in when you sell a policy, the more the policy's worth. So we've sold policies that are $1 million policies to people that are not in great health. And we got up to $80,000, $90,000 for a policy that normally the client was going to let lapse and let go. They weren't aware of the fact that they can sell it. And when they came to us, we said, no, let's see if we can get a quote for you. We got a $90,000 quote on one of them for $1 million. And the client sold it to that company and they took the $1 million. Some people use it for extra retirement money if they need it. So it's kind of like an insurance policy on an insurance policy. It's kind of like an option on your life, if you will, that you know is going to pay off someday, whether you die, keep the policy, or whether you want to sell it. It's an investment, in my opinion. I've never seen a policy where you can buy a policy that's term and get less back. You're never going to get less than zero back for it. Worst case is you're in great health. There may not be a lot of time left on the term contract before it expires, and therefore it doesn't have a big value. And especially if it's not convertible, there's probably very little value in that, but probably worth more than zero. And that's the point. Before you throw it out the window or decide not to pay the premium any longer, don't let them lapse. Let us get you a quote on that scenario. So there's a lot of moving parts when it comes to life insurance. There's a lot of different ways to do it. And experience counts, and we're going to talk about that on our third session today of the program. We're going to take a short break, but before I go, I'm going to say this. If you'd like some help as to what to do right now with your life insurance plan, if you want us to review it, sometimes we can upgrade your insurance very easily. We can do that with a copy of an old statement. And you on the telephone, when we call the insurance company, it's just about a 10-minute review. It doesn't take long. We get all the ins and outs, but while we're at it, we'll check the beneficiaries and make sure the beneficiaries are correct. Because remember, life insurance payable to a named beneficiary to that beneficiary if you die is totally income tax free. Life insurance to an estate is fully taxable to that estate. So we can keep the tax plan for the government out of your affairs by simply naming a beneficiary, wife, children, aunt, uncle, neighbor, somebody, charity, whatever. But keep it to a named beneficiary. Don't bring it into your estate. It's the worst place to have a life insurance policy payable to. So that's the essence of that scenario. But nevertheless, we're here to help you. So what you do is you call 252-249-0100. That's 252-249-0100. For a full financial plan guarantee, we will analyze your Social Security, make sure we maximize that out for you. We use Dr. Larry Kotlikoff, our nation's expert on Social Security. We want to give you every drop of money you've got coming in your Social Security benefit. You've paid in a lot of money for over 100,000 hours of work. We want to get as much back out of that as possible between your ages 62 and 70. We know how to maximize it out. Dr. Kotlikoff designed our software. We use his software to do it, and we will max your Social Security. We'll help you with your pension plan. We'll help give you lifetime income from your 401ks, your defined benefit pensions, your savings, your qualified money, your non-qualified money, which means after tax savings. Put it all together and design a lifetime income plan. And we either even design a plan that will help pay your life insurance premium so that you got money behind you that we can create magically if something happens to you, whether you live or die. Remember, our life insurance plans pay both ways. We pay if you die, we pay your family. If you live and you can't do 2 of 6, we call that living death. We pay you the death benefit in your hand while you're alive. So imagine you collecting the full face amount of your life insurance policy in your hand to help you get through the rest of life in a comfortable manner with dignity. That's what it's all about. If neither occurs and you purchase under age 70, we have a refund of premium plan that'll give you 100% of all of your money back after 20 years. So it's the best of everything. We call it all the master plan. Let us help you to help yourself. And when you finish, we'll have it in writing for you. There's no charge for the plan, no charge for the meeting, no charge for anything. Just let us help you to help yourself. And we get the benefit of helping you, and you get the benefit of our 41 years of experience and all of our coaches that we pay as well. We got the best coaches in the U.S., in my opinion. We got 12 of them, and they're very, very good coaches. So give us a call right now at 252-249-0100. We'll press a couple of buttons and get you a life insurance quote, if nothing more. When you'd like to know what it's going to cost you to get $100,000 or $1 million or whatever you want in between, we can do that for you very quickly. In about 10 minutes, we'll have a quote right in your hand, and you can look at it and see if it makes sense. And if you're healthy, we'll get you qualified. Number to call, 252-249-0100. When we come back, we're going to be sitting down with Dan Pilla, the nation's expert on taxation and on helping you to get out of a tax problem, if you have one, legally, and staying above water. And that's crucial to every listener that's on this radio station today. Dan Pilla coming up next on the program. We'll be right back. Don't go away. There's more to come live right here on the Mastering Your Money Show. We'll be right back.
Happy anniversary. Happy anniversary.
We're back, Gary Master Donato, the Master of Your Money Show, August edition, 2022. Hard to believe here we are in August already. And not hard to believe all the goings-on with the news lately and some of the different bills that are just about to be passed or going to be passed. And one of the biggest bills going through Congress right now is the new inflation trending. It's supposed to be helping inflation, but I got a feeling it's going to be adding to the inflationary period. We've asked Dan Pilla, who literally wrote the book on sound taxation and one of the nation's experts on helping people like you and I, the listener, to help ourselves through the tough times of defending ourselves against the heavy taxes because, you know, inflation's going higher, but so are taxes. So, Dan, welcome to the program, the Master of Your Money Show, sir.
Hey, it's my pleasure, Gary. Thanks for having me.
Yes, and I should say welcome back. You've been on several times already, and we appreciate that. You know, in reading a little bit about you and what you do, and I speak to you personally often on the telephone, you literally wrote the book on sound taxation. I mean, I know you earn your living not by preparing tax returns. You don't do that, although your daughter does that for us in a very professional, beautiful way, but by defending people who already have been targeted by the IRS. And the author of many books on taxes includes the following quote in your pamphlet, which I love. It says, "All of the powers conferred upon government, that of taxation, is most liable to abuse." And nothing more to be said other than this new bill now that they just passed, and it seems like nothing more than added abuse. Let's talk about that bill for a minute, Dan.
Yeah, what we're talking about here, Gary, is the Inflation Reduction Act. This is the Biden administration's reincarnation of Build Back Better. And this is the bill, Gary, that's going to raise taxes by almost $1 trillion. And this is bad policy for a number of reasons. First of all, you never raise taxes in a recession. You know, that's just basic fundamental economics. You do not raise taxes in a recession, but they want to raise taxes by almost $1 trillion. Of course, the spending on top of that is 3 or 4 times what that would be. But the other part of this bill that portends disaster for the typical taxpayer is the IRS funding portion of the bill. This bill contains additional funding to the IRS over and above their typical annual budget appropriations, which is roughly $12.5 billion. They want to give the IRS another $8 billion a year for the next 10 years, so $80 billion more dollars, $8 billion a year, on top of the $12.5 billion they already have. So we're talking about almost doubling the IRS's operating budget year over year here. And the thing that's worse than that, Gary, it's one thing to give the IRS money. It's another thing to look at how the IRS is going to spend that money. About $3.1 billion of those dollars, call it $3.2 billion of those dollars, is going to be directed to taxpayer assistance and education. Well, okay, people need help, Gary, no question about that. We got a tax code that consists of more than 4 million words that's been changed more than 5,900 times just since 2001 alone. People need help complying. There's no question about that. But look at the other side of the coin. The other side of the coin is over $45.5 billion is going to be specifically earmarked for enforcement, including increased audits and collection and litigation and so on. So in this tug of war, Gary, between taxpayer assistance and tax law enforcement is a winner by more than 14-1. at a time when the tax code has never been more confusing, has never been more convoluted, has never gone through more changes. You know, we've seen dozens of changes in just the last 2.5 years with these COVID changes. People are adrift in a sea of tax law changes, and they need help. And instead of getting that help, the IRS just wants to put the boot on the neck of the American taxpayer. And my problem with this is really this simple. The amount of money that the federal government collects through quote-unquote voluntary payments versus enforcement action is 98% to 2%. So in other words, 98% of every federal dollar paid in is paid, you know, quote-unquote voluntarily. And what I mean by that is without IRS intervention. Only 2% of the revenue collected, almost $4 trillion, is collected through enforcement action. Only 2% through enforcement action, 98% voluntarily. So where do you think, Gary, you'd get the most bang for the buck if you're going to fund a particular function? Are you going to help people comply? People want to comply, Gary. Nobody wants to get sideways with the IRS. If people know what the law requires of them, they will do what the law requires. All right? So you're obviously better off funding education and assistance than enforcement. Now, I'm not saying they shouldn't fund enforcement, but you know what? This 14-to-1 ratio is so far out of whack, it's not even funny. It doesn't even address or respect the hard realities that only 2% of the revenue collected is collected through enforcement action. This is my biggest problem with this bill. I can make a laundry list of my problems with the bill, Gary, but this is huge on my list, is this inequitable balance between enforcement and education. It's just, it's irrational and it's bad policy.
Well, it sounds horrible, and it sounds horrible to the average taxpayer. Now, the president, when he was elected and brought this bill out initially, indicated that there would be no tax increases for anyone earning below $400,000. As you see it, is there a tax increase for us little guys as well, or just the $400,000 plus?
Well, how about we forget my opinion and let's look at the reports of the Joint Tax Committee of Congress, which is a nonpartisan team of economists and analysts that look at the revenue impacts of any bill, not just this Inflation Reduction Act, which is a misnomer, by the way. But they score every, this is the scoring process that they use, all right? When you see the government saying, well, we're going to collect X billion dollars doing this, X billion dollars doing that, the administration comes up with its numbers. But the Joint Tax Committee is the one that does the independent, nonpartisan scoring. And they're telling us, Gary, according to their scores, they're telling us that about 35% of all this additional revenue, almost $1 trillion, is going to come from people earning under $200,000 a year, never mind under $400,000, under $200,000 a year. So it is just simply not true that the administration is only taxing the high-income earners in excess of $400,000. It's just not true.
So how does Congress continue to carry on and look in the camera's eye, especially the people who write these bills and passing the bills, and even the president who gets up there and repeats over and over again, we're not raising taxes on anyone who's earning under $400,000, I repeat. And even Joe Manchin yesterday on the news, I saw him when he crossed over the line there to make this bill potentially pass. I guess it gets voted on. But nevertheless, you know, they look square in the camera and just continue that horrid lie about where the money's coming from. And it's coming from us little guys. You know, inflation is a tax increase without legislation.
Yeah, there's no question about it, Gary. Okay. In fact, I got an article that was published on National Review here, National Review Online, just recently that talks about this very issue, the hidden tax of inflation. And I use the state of Minnesota as an example. The state of Minnesota now has a budget surplus, Gary, of about $9.3 billion. That's over and above the projected revenue collections. They're sitting on $9.3 billion of taxpayers' money. And, of course, the debate now is how do we spend this windfall, not whether we should give it back to the taxpayers who own the money. But here's the fascinating part of this surplus. About $6 billion of that money comes from sales tax surplus. In other words, the projected sales tax revenue for the state of Minnesota between 2020 and 2021 was supposed to be about $6.5 billion. They collected over $13 billion during that period of time. Now, Gary, this was at a time when the economy of the state was shut down. Right? Businesses were shuttered. People were ordered to stay home. How is it that they could have this windfall of sales tax revenue at a time when the economy was shut down? Well, remember that the federal government handed out about $9 trillion worth of free benefits to people, and they spent the money, all right? And they spend the money, and now we've got this inflation. We've got double-digit inflation, and they're reporting, you know, 10, 11%, but Gary, I just know it's worse than that. I mean, just look at the fuel prices and the cost of food that's gone up here. Gas has doubled in the last 2 years. And so when you buy these products and services in the marketplace, there's sales tax attached to them. That's a tax increase. It's an effective tax increase, even though there's no rate increase. And this is the hidden hammer of inflation that pounds the middle class and the folks that are on fixed income, hits them hard because they don't have the luxury of just raising prices.
Well, they don't. And the president gets on and boasts about the fact that now there's an X amount of, I think, 15% of the country's gas stations now offer fuel for under $4 a gallon. And he's taunting that as a win. And it's not a win. You know, talking about the percentage of inflation, Dan, I did my own calculation and bringing gas, because the increase in gas of fuel and food is not included in that 11.3 or whatever the government says it is. I calculated out with all the things that are included on an average consumption basis, talking to a couple of economists that we talked to on the radio program, up 23.7% annual rate of inflation right now. Based on fuel and food, and do the math, like you said, gas has doubled. I know it's doubled for every American out there, and food as well. I mean, you know, when I buy a bunch of spinach now for $3.29, they used to be 99 cents 7 or 8 months ago. That's a big increase. That's triple. But still in all, there's other, most prices of food have gone up. Nothing has come down. And when things are on sale, they're still far above the normal price they used to be. So,
yeah, that's exactly right. Gary, you make a very, very important point that people need to understand. And that is, when you look at the consumer price index, that does not include fuel. By definition, it does not include fuel, it does not include food, and it does not include durable goods like houses and cars. All right? And look at what's happened to the housing market. And so when we're talking about the consumer price index, we're talking about T-shirts and hairbrushes. And these are things that people can easily leave behind, but they can't leave behind fuel, they can't leave behind food, and they can't leave behind housing. And these are the things that are crushing people right now.
And rents, too. Rents have skyrocketed in every major city, and even small towns like our own in Oriental. Yep. Rents have skyrocketed as well. So the average consumer, Dan, is pegged against the wall. And now they're raising taxes additionally with this bill. I don't know where they get their sound freedom from. Obviously, it's an election year. Obviously, they're trying to save their behinds on the left side. And I think it's going to backfire on them. We'll see what happens in November. The individual has a chance to vote. And that's what they're going to express their opinion on and their fact on is to vote. So get out there and vote when it comes that time. You know, Dan, for many, many years, you and I have been in contact with each other and talking on the phone and doing some work together. And you've done a great job. You've written many books. You've helped so many individuals out on staying out of trouble with the IRS. Like you said, we don't want to get into trouble. We're trying to comply. And I, for one, and my assistants, we got three assistants here. We all tried to reach the federal tax government number that's on the internet, the 800 number. We've been calling for several weeks and on hold sometimes for two and a half hours. And then they hang up, not able to get through and talk to a human being. That's where we need to put staffing, not on the enforcement side, but on the compliance side.
Well, yeah, and this goes along with my point that the money should be spent on education and assistance. Taxpayer education programs, teaching people how to file their tax returns, how to keep their records, how to do these things that the IRS requires people to do, but there's no education for any of this stuff. Look, Gary, if you've got a high school diploma, you've spent about 14,000 hours in school over those years, right? If you've got a college degree, then add, you know, X thousand more hours to that study process. In all of that time, you haven't spent 10 minutes in a classroom understanding what tax law requirements are. So you're a high school senior, you're out there with a job, you could even be a junior or even a sophomore out there with a job someplace. You have no idea what the tax compliance requirements are because this stuff is never taught. Even the best business schools in the country, Gary, don't teach these tax basics that people need to know. And I'll tell you something else. Taxes is an elective in law school. Most lawyers graduate law school. They've never had any classes on taxes. So this is an astonishing level of ignorance of our tax system and a dearth of knowledge and information on the tax system. And this is where the IRS should be spending its energy, helping people to comply, not grinding them into powder when they don't comply.
Absolutely. Amen on that, my friend. I couldn't agree with you better. And, you know, they don't teach finance either. I mean, people come out of college, you got doctors, attorneys, professionals with master's degrees and PhDs, and they don't really have any acumen when it comes to basic finance 101. I mean, you got an average American, Dan, talking about hours worked or spent doing something. The average American spends over 100,000 hours in their work career, 100,000 hours.
Yeah.
And, you know, since January 1st, if you got all your money in your 401k and you're in just an average 401k investor in a balanced type of portfolio, your account has dropped 21% on average from January 1st to June 30. Okay. Now,
yep.
Not, will it come back? Yeah, it may come back. It may not. It may take a long time to come back. The point is they've given up 20,000 hours of deposits to their plan and value in that,
right,
in that drop. So when you're retired or about to retire, ladies and gentlemen, protect your money from the downside. Protect those hours you worked. You can't get the hours back. And the same with taxes. Hey, listen, if the government wants you to pay taxes, it'd be a simple 3x5 card. How much did you earn? Minus out your children or whatever you got on there. And you send this amount in and that's it. But Dan, you said there's what, 40 million words in the tax law? I mean, that's a lot of words.
About 4 million words, Gary. Million words in the tax code,
right,
which is plenty enough,
yeah,
especially when you look at it in context. In the year 2000, so we're talking 20-plus years ago, the code consisted of about 1.3 million words. All right, then it goes through 5,900 code changes, law changes over the next 20 years, and now we got 4 million words. And what's astonishing about the law changes is every single one of these things was sold to us by Congress as tax simplification.
Exactly.
All right, we're going to have more tax simplification, Gary. Every time they simplify the law, it gets longer and more complicated and more difficult to comply with.
Well, it's absolutely true. And I'll tell you, I think the government really doesn't want us to pay a tax because they've given us enough reasons not to pay in those 4 million words. But yet you got to know how to play the game. It's a chess game. And you know how to play it better than anyone I've ever met. You and my friend Tom Weatherall, CPA, and a couple of other people that they can fit in one hand really know the tax rules inside and out. Outside of that, ladies and gentlemen, you got to do your homework. And the same with finance. You know, there's not a whole lot of people that know finance, and you can't replace experience. Dan, you've been in this business 40 plus years. Is that correct?
Yeah, that's right. 40 plus years.
And I've been in 41 years as of August 1st. So, you know, we celebrated anniversaries and we got a lot of experience. You can't replace experience. You know, and the cool thing is, I always tell people, Dan, as you see it right now in your practice as well, from being in business so long, is we see the back end of the work we do on the front end. Most
right.
people cannot see that. Okay. Most young advisors, and bless their hearts, they got to learn. But if they've been in business 3 or 4 years or 5 years doing a tax return or doing a financial plan, they can't foresee what happens when you retire and you're 20 years out and mama's got Alzheimer's and papa's got a disability and they started with $1 million in the retirement plan and now they're going to run out of money before they die. And that's the problem in America. And that's what we try to fix here. And I know you try to do that as well. You know, on your website, Dan, I was looking at epicconsumptiontax.org. Is that one of your sites?
Well, that's not one of my sites, Gary. That's a site for an organization in Nebraska that I was working with pretty extensively in January to try to get their state income tax repealed.
Okay, because I see a video here that says Saturday morning cross training center. Was that? Okay.
Yeah, that was a session that I spoke at that they videoed that we put on our website. That's where that came from.
Well, it's important to know that you not only cross-train, you do a lot of educational training, as you indicated earlier. And we thank you for what you do, Mr. Dan Pilla. Dan, what's the best way to reach you for a listener who would like to call and get some information firsthand from what you can offer a taxpayer?
Yeah, Gary, your listeners can go straight to my website, which is taxhelponline.com. It's all one word, no spaces of any kind, taxhelponline.com. And if you buy any book at any price point off my site, Gary, not from any place else, but my site, you get a free 15-minute consultation directly with me. So you get a chance to read the book, write your questions down, get on my appointment schedule, and I'll walk you right through the answers to all your questions to give you the guidance you need. So go to taxhelponline.com to get that set up.
And I can tell you this, I've never asked you a question you could not answer immediately. I mean, you've got the answers, you've got the knowledge, you got the experience, and you got the know-how. And most importantly, you're willing to share that with the public, and we thank you for all you do. It's really a dedication to the industry and a dedication to the taxpayer to help us to help themselves. So Dan Pilla, thanks so much for joining us live on the Mastering Your Money Show. We'll have you back again soon because we need you. And as this bill unwinds, it'll be interesting to see how it does unwind. And I want to get your take on it once it unwinds, and we'll get you back on the program and talk about that very subject. Thank you, Dan Pilla.
Absolutely, and I'll look forward to it, Gary. Thank you very much.
I'm Gary Mastrodonato. We're just talking with Dan Pilla. Again, that's taxhelponline.com, and best informational mind in the industry, in my opinion. Dan, there's not a question you can ask him that he cannot answer and help you to help yourself. We're going to take a short break. We'll be back with more of the Mastering Your Money program right after these words from my very favorite sponsor. Guess who that is? We'll be right back.
Honey, 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 you're so money, money, money. You got a country road, Carolina soul. Baby, you're just so homegrown.
We're back. Gary Mastrodonato, the Mastering Your Money Show. You know, in business 41 years. On radio now, 40 years. Happy anniversary, Gary. Thank you, Jeff, and listeners out there. And it's an anniversary show. 40 years, August 1. We're very proud of that, to be on Financial Radio Live. And never a show with a note. I'm proud of that. I never used a note or compendium or of anything on the show. We always talk about the stuff that people care about most, the stuff that's going on in the real world, and the stuff that you want to talk about and hear about today. You know, we advise a lot of financial advisors around the U.S., and that's what they want to hear about as well. They'll call me with financial problems that their clients have. And God gave me a great gift, and that's a gift to solve a financial problem pretty quickly for a client. He took away the gift of being able to build a bookshelf or tune a car or anything like that. I just don't have the acumen, but I can solve a financial problem immediately, and I can see the solutions all before my eyes almost instantly.
So well, I know where not to bring my car, Gary. I'm not going to bring it to you.
Well, don't bring it to me, but bring your financial plan to me.
Exactly.
And I'll get that baby running smooth and forever. That's the key. The car runs forever if it's an equivalent of a financial plan with the master. Our clients not only retire, they stay retired all the way through in dignity, and that's crucial and key, in dignity. So, you know, you do deserve to move your financial life forward. That's why we do this program. It's educational, but also there's a lot of ideas in here that you can use on a daily basis. And, you know, we always touch the basics, but the most important thing to know is that we're here for you. We got the answers. And, you know, when you have experience, an experience of 41 years, we see what goes into the front end of a client's portfolio, an IRA account, a pension plan, a life insurance premium, whatever that is. We also see what comes out the back end of that same plan. So we can see how they work. And a lot of the financial advisors folks, unfortunately, and I don't blame them totally because they're taught like that from the companies they work for to garner activity. But, you know, when you're doing life insurance, for example, and you're looking at the difference of a whole life policy versus a IUL policy, which is an indexed universal life policy, or a GUL, which is a guaranteed universal life policy, they're different as day and night. And people don't know that. And they're not taught to sell the GUL policies because there's probably more profit to the insurance company in the IULs. And at the time, sometimes they don't know that because they're young and they're not there on the other end. They're taught to like front load a policy, put as much money as you can. Don't worry about death benefit. Put as much money as you can on the front end. Make sure it's a non-MEC, a non-modified endowment contract, so there's no taxation due. And then technically let it cook for 10 or 15 years and then pull the money out and use that as tax-free income. Did you ever hear that from your advisor or from a book you might have read somewhere, providing tax-free retirement money to you? And it works on paper, but in the real world of experience, when you get out to the back end where you're starting to take the money out, and that's where the experience comes in. When we run what's called an in-force illustration, which is the MRI of your insurance policy, we see the workings on the internal of what it looks like. And if you took that money out that they said you can take out the day you bought it, that policy would go underwater in about 3 to 5 years on average, sometimes sooner. And that's assuming you didn't touch any of the money along the way. And what happens then is you get a nasty letter from the insurance company that says your policy is going to lapse in 6 months, or put in $90,000 of new premium, and we'll keep the policy going for another 2 or 3 years. You know, before the show today, Jeff and I called my insurance provider, my insurance agency that we use, to get some quotes on life insurance. And one of the quotes we got was for a male age 66. And why do we do that? Because it's kind of an average age that people think about buying life insurance when they're just about retired, if they work till 66. And they sit down with me and we're going through the financial plan and we notice they have no insurance, or the insurance they had at work is no longer in force because it's no longer active. Why is it not active? Because what happened was it kind of runs out of steam. It runs out of steam because there's no more coverage at their age when they leave the employee, or it drops down significantly. You might have had five times your salary while you're working there. The day you walk out on retirement, it's worth 1/10 of your salary. And it's a big drop. And then you have no other insurance. And if you're not insurable, you're in big trouble because you can't get insurance at a good rate or at a good price, or maybe not at all. Maybe you're declined. A lot of people get declined on a regular basis. So that happens as well. If you have a change in health, you're not insurable anymore. If you get diagnosed with cancer tomorrow morning, you're no longer insurable. If you get diagnosed with something that's going to shorten your lifespan, you're no longer insurable. If you've been cancer-free for the last 5 years, there's a good chance we can get your life insurance at standard rates today. Where in the old days, if you had cancer, you weren't even looked at forever for the rest of your lifetime. So that's a big change in life insurance underwriting as well. If you've had COVID with the COVID world, that's a big change as well, because the life insurance companies have changed their COVID underwriting quite a bit, and they've taken away a lot of the automatic standard issues or preferred issues and replaced them with standard issues because the morbidity is so high in a COVID environment. So many more deaths occurred. You know, life expectancy, Jeffrey, I'm not sure if you're aware of this, but in the last 3 years, life expectancy has actually decreased.
Right, right.
Instead of increased. We talked about that in previous shows.
Mm-hmm.
Life expectancy went down by 1 or 2 years due to the high numbers of death in COVID and the large numbers of death in the younger sector with drug overdoses and suicides. So those numbers are throwing off the life expectancy factors. And unfortunately, they raise the life insurance rates when that occurs. So there's a lot of changes in underwriting, some good, some not so favorable for the insured. But we need to find out where you stand. And you know, Jeffrey, I'll tell you this, whether you buy term, whole life, IUL, GUL, VUL, or call it whatever you want, I've delivered lots of death benefit checks in my career, 41 years. I never had a widow on the day I delivered the check, $1 million, $500,000. They never asked, by the way, did my husband have whole life, IUL, term? What kind of insurance was this? It doesn't matter because it pays the same amount of money tax-free the same way, whether it's term insurance, whole life. The only difference is the only life insurance that counts, ladies and gentlemen, is the insurance policy that's in force the day you die. It doesn't help if it peters out 6 months before you die. There's no benefit on that plan. So you want to make sure that's why people will go the longer stretch with the whole life or the IUL, insurance that does not run out of time before you run out of time. And that's the key. So the number to call, 252-249-0100, get that all-important life insurance quote. We will sit down with you and figure out what you got. If you have existing insurance, that's great, because oftentimes we can use what you got, if you're healthy, and use the cash value for what you got to help buy the new premium at a lot lesser discount. We'll show you the little tricks of the trade to enhance your insurability prospects from that as well. Number to call, 252-249-0100. If you want help as to what to do right now with your life insurance plan, to analyze if you need life insurance in your retirement stage or near retirement, to analyze if you need a long-term care plan that everybody should have today, it's so crucial, and you don't have a plan for retirement unless you have a plan for long-term care, you want to call us right now at 252-249-0100. Myself and my entire team we'll sit down and structure the best financial plan you've probably have ever seen for yourself in your day. And you'll walk away wondering, why didn't my person do that for me? Or why has that never brought up to me before? Or why didn't they put this plan in my place? Or why don't I have lifetime income in my plan? Why does my plan run out of money if I spend too much, or if the economy changes, or we go through inflationary periods for a long time? Inflation is killing what's going on in America right now, and we can't afford to have any more deeper inflation than what we have. And inflation, sadly, will continue to go up for a while yet. a long time for a while yet. So let me know about how that's going to work. We'll take a short break. When we come back, we'll wrap up the program. So the number to call, 252-249-0100, the Retirement Planning Distribution Specialist. Use us. We've got the talent. We've got the team. And I think you're very lucky to have our structure and our professional strategies and experience right in your backyard. We got people that drive 3 or 4 hours to come see me. And for you, it's local right here in the backyard. So give us a call at 252-249-0100. We'll be right back. Don't go away.
Too. You got me frustrated, and I don't know what to do. I'm trying to make a living. I can't save a cent. It takes all of my money just to eat and pay my rent. I got the blues. Got those inflation blues. Yes, I have.
We're back. Gary Master Donato, the Master of the Money Show. You know, we're summarizing today's show. We had a great show. We talked about a lot of things. We talked about life insurance, the importance of life insurance, whether you're just starting off in life or just retiring in life. You still need the insurance for different reasons at different times. And the new insurance contracts today, folks, will give you a special option for long-term care coverage that you didn't have before and the former insurance plan. So if you got an older plan and if you're healthy, we can convert that into the newer plan. As long as you're healthy, we can get you underwritten and approved and use any cash you may have accumulated in that plan to help you get the new insurance. Or if you have term insurance, if it's convertible, we can use that in our corner to switch to the newer plan. So there's a lot of options we can use. As importantly, we'll check your beneficiaries to make sure they're going to a named beneficiary and make sure they're going to the right beneficiaries. You know, beneficiaries die along the way, just like other folks do. People change, you divorce, you know, your ex-spouse is no longer in primary position, but in many cases they are. The ex-spouse is on many things still in plans, and I'll tell you, current spouses don't like that. I could tell you personally, as they walk out of my office when we call the home office of the insurance companies to confirm who's on the plan. And remember this, if you change a beneficiary on a piece of paper and your advisor just puts the paper in his file and never sends it off to the insurance company, that insurance change has not taken place until it officially goes to the custodian of that insurance company, and they process it, and they put it in their file, and then they verify to you that the policy beneficiary has been changed. If that hasn't occurred, your former beneficiary, even though you got the form in your advisor's file cabinet, does not take place. It has no legal bearing whatsoever in the court of law. It's going to go to the one that the insurance company has processed last. So you got to make sure you follow up on those. We fix about 4 mistakes every quarter just on that, where the policy beneficiary has been changed, they think. In the big picture, they have not been changed. They never were changed because they were changed on paper, but it was never sent in to the home office. So that's crucial. We also had Dan Pilla on today to talk about tax problems and how to fix them. He's an educator, and he's here to help us to help you. And you go to taxhelponline.com. And as Dan said, if you buy any one of his books on his website, he will give you a 15-minute free consultation. And I'll tell you, that man in 15 minutes can give you 6 years worth of education because he's got it all up in the brain. Somebody told me yesterday, they made a comment, and I thought it was very nice. They said, Gary, you're very smart. You're very well-rounded. You know so much about so many things. How long did it take you to learn all this? I said, well, I've been in business 41 years. But you got to bear in mind, when I go back and look at the training that I've had through all the major wirehouse firms, Payne Weber, E.F. Hutton, A.G. Edwards, Smith Barney, Dean Witter, all the major firms, and then on our own all the way through, and all the coaching we've had and sessions I've attended, I literally have millions of dollars worth of training up in my head. So take advantage of that while I'm still can still remember all these things. And I'm telling you, I love this business more every day. We're full of energy, vip, and vinegar. So let's take care of, and let's take care of your situation right now. So here's my final call to action. If you want help as to what to do right now with your complete financial plan, we've got a tough time out here with higher inflation. We've got rising interest rates. We have double-digit inflation. We have stagflation. We're in a possible recession. I think we're in recession. Definitionally, we are. We're at a very volatile market, and there's a lot more selling to come. Don't be misled by this little rally we've been getting the last couple of days. It's not a true rally. It's not going to put where you want to be in the long picture. And I'm telling you, this is not where you want to be. You want to be in the master plan. You want to have your money safer, and you want to have it there for the rest of your life. You want income for the rest of your life. And if you die, you want money to go to your family for their plan. And if you live, you want money to come into your hands for your plan for long-term care, so you don't run out of money and can live in dignity for the rest of your life. That's what we offer you today. We're giving it to you for free. There's no obligation on your part. All you need to do is call 252-249-0100. That's 252-249-0100. Myself and my entire team will sit down with you, give us 20 minutes of your time on the telephone, and we will give you 41 years of experience and all of our coaches, all for you, and all on a platter called the Master Plan. So that's about it right now. I'm Gary Master Donato, along with my prestigious co-host, Mr. Jeff Shea. Jeffrey, thank you for your help, sir.
It's always a pleasure, Gary.
And all of our staff, we have Eric, we have Sue, we have Trish, we have Rebecca, we have Christina, we have Tracy, we have Diana, we have the entire team. They're all working hard for you to help keep your money above water, to keep your income in, and to keep your family in dignity. I'm Gary Master Donato, and along with God, we thank you there, Heavenly Father, for the guidance you give us to keep our clients' money safe and to keep our clients healthy. In Jesus' name we pray. Have a great week. See you all again next weekend right here live on the Mastering Your Money Show.
No statements made during the Mastering Your Money Show shall constitute tax, legal, or accounting advice. You should consult your own legal or tax professional on your individual information. Past performance is not a guarantee of future results. No investment strategy, including asset allocation or diversification, guarantees a profit or the avoidance of loss.